Good morning children, welcome back to chemistry session. In previous session we have seen reaction of non-metal oxides with bases and reaction of metal oxides with an acids. In today's session we are going to talk about what do all acids and bases in common. Let us start today's session children. What do all acids and bases have in common? In previous activity, we have seen that when acids react with metals and produce hydrogen gas, bases reacts with metals and produce hydrogen gas. That means hydrogen atom is common in most of the acids, but there are some compounds which contain hydrogen atom but they do not act as acids. The compounds like alcohol, formaldehyde, C2H5OH and urea form NH2CO, NH2 and sugar or glucose. Sugar form C12H22O11 or glucose form C6H12O6. So there are some of the compounds, they contain hydrogen atoms. So are they comes under acids or not? Let us see children. By doing activity, by doing this activity, we can conclude that the compounds which contain hydrogen atoms, whether they classified acids or not. Let us see children. For doing this activity, we require some apparatus like 200 ml beakers, 200 ml beakers, and we have to place rubber cork. We have to fix rubber cork in the beakers and fix two iron nails on the rubber cork. Fix two iron nails on the rubber cork. Now fill the beakers. Label them as A and B. Fill baker A with aqueous glucose solution. Aqueous glucose solution. Glucose formula C6H12O6. And fill baker B with aqueous hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid. Aqueous hydrochloric acid solution. Its formula HCl. Now connect the terminals of the iron nail with the battery. Connect the terminals of the iron nail with the battery. Bulbs as well as switch. This is battery children. This is bulb and this is plug key. Plug key or switch. So the circuit contains bulb, switch and battery. Similarly, in the second breaker or breaker P, connect the terminals of the battery with bulb and switch. This is bulb and this is plug to the switch and this is battery. This is the experimental arrangement of the activity. Now, when electricity passes through the iron nails in both the vehicles, we can notice that bulb glows in beaker B, but not in beaker A. This is because beaker A contains aqueous glucose solution and beaker B contains aqueous hydrochloric acid solution. When electricity passes through the iron nails, then this aqueous hydrochloric acid means hydrochloric acid is present in the water. It contains HCl plus H2O. So this HCl can be ionized into aqueous solution. This HCl can be ionized into H3O plus ions. H3O plus ions and Cl minus ions. That means this HCl in aqueous solution produce H3O plus ions. H3O plus ions and Cl minus ions. This H3O plus ions are H plus ions. H3O plus ions are H plus ions present at one iron nail and Cl minus liberated at another iron nail. That means a compound is separated into its respective ions. Here in aqueous medium, HCl is ionized into H plus and Cl minus ions. So these ions are responsible for the glowing of bulb in the activity. That is the reason why bulb glows only in beaker B, because ions are present in the beaker. So these ions are responsible for the glowing of bulb in the beaker B. This is called ionic electricity. Ionic electricity means electricity is generated by ions. Because in aqueous solution, hydrochloric acid produce ions. These ions are responsible for the glowing of bulb in the beaker B. Coming to beaker A. Here, beaker A contains aqueous glucose solution. What will happen when glucose is dissolved in water? When glucose is dissolved in water, CH3OH6, when we add glucose to water, which forms glucose solution, and doesn't produce any ions, in the beaker A. That is the reason why bulb doesn't glow in beaker A. So based on this activity, we conclude that the compounds which contain hydrogen atom, they are all not considered as acids, because the compounds which produce hydronium ions are H plus ions in aqueous solution, those are considered as acids. Here, the compounds like glucose and ethyl alcohol, formula of ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH, and urea formula NH2CO NH2. These compounds contain hydrogen atom. Though they contain hydrogen atoms, they are not considered as acids, because in aqueous solution they do not produce ions. So when there is no ions in the aqueous solution, the bulb doesn't glow in beaker A. That's why, though the compounds like glucose, ethyl alcohol and urea, they contain hydrogen atoms, they are not considered as acids. So based on this activity, we conclude that hydrogen atom is common in all acids, and acids means the substances which produce hydronium ions or H plus ions in aqueous solution. So the compounds which produce or furnish H plus ions are H3O plus ions in aqueous solution.
are called as acids, but not the compounds like glucose, ethyl alcohol and urea are not considered as acids, though they contain hydrogen atom. Repeat the activity with bases. So what do we notice when we replace hydrochloric acid by bases like sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide? When we repeat the activity by either sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, in aqueous solution the sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide can produce ions, the respective ions Na plus ions and OH minus ions. Similarly, potassium hydroxide in aqueous solution, this potassium hydroxide is ionized into K plus and OH minus ions. So these ions are present at different iron ions. OH minus ions present at one iron ion, and either sodium ions or potassium ions are present at another iron ion. So ions are liberated in the aqueous solutions. So these ions are responsible for the conduction of electricity. So in case of bases, OH minus ions are liberated, or OH minus ions are produced in the aqueous solution. So these OH minus ions are responsible for the glowing of bulb in the beaker beam. So in first case, H plus ions are, H3O plus ions are responsible for the beaker beam in case of acids. In case of bases, OH minus ions are the responsible for the glowing of bulb in the beaker beam. So based on this activity, we conclude that H plus ions or H3O plus ions are formation by the acids in aqueous solutions, and OH minus ions are formation by the bases in aqueous solution. That is the reason why bulb glows in aqueous solutions of acid and bases, because ions are liberated in the aqueous solution. Those ions are responsible for the conduction of electricity. This is known as ionic conductance, because ions are responsible for the glowing of bulb in the beaker. So this is today's section, children. Today's section is nothing but what do all acids and bases have in common. Based on this activity, we conclude that H plus ions are, H3O plus ions are generated by or produced by acids in aqueous solution, as well as OH minus ions are produced by bases in aqueous solution. So this is today's section, children. I hope you understand today's section, children. We will meet in next section. Thank you, children.